Welcome to Thoroughbred Action at Gulfstream Park. I'm Katie Stazak. Welcome to a fresh week of racing here at Gulfstream. We're starting things up today on Friday, and we have a 10-race program on tap. That includes the Hard Worker Stakes featuring Grade 2 winner R Free Roll. Plus, we are starting fresh in the Rainbow Six after Monday's mandatory payout. It's going to be another fun day of racing. Here are the track and weather conditions.
The main track is fast and the turf course is firm. The first race on Friday's card is a $12,500 claiming event. Three-year-olds and up will be sprinting 5 furlongs on the turf course. No scratches or jockey changes to report in the opener.
Racing at Gulfstream. Picture perfect beginning. Race back toward the inside begins nicely from the top shelf. Starship Sulu is moving forward in between horses. That's running alone alongside Why Not Grey Boy. Off to speed from fifth is It's Time to Laugh with You and Tequila on the inside of him. It's a length and a half to start up. The two at the back are JC50 and Bluegrass Derby. They leave the backstretch and take it to the far turn. Starship Sulu bids up to take a short lead. Race back, tries to fight back second. Why Not Grey Boy is now third from running alone fourth. You and Tequila is fifth. It's Time to Laugh moving between horses. For Prado, he's in the clear now and starting to move closer. Startup is going to swing wide for the drive, but he'll have every opportunity, and they're at the top of the stretch. Cutting the corner, Ray's back still in front. From the outside, Starship Sulu comes alongside, and from the outside, It's Time to Laugh is very confidently handled, and he just motored up to take the lead. Startup is his late threat. It's Time to Laugh by two. Startup's into second. It's Time to Laugh is in front by 2.5. Second is Startup. It's close third. Maybe Bluegrass Derby might have got up in 56-2.
It's Time to Laugh easily runs down the front runners in the first race, notching his second victory in a row for trainer David Casson. Edgar Prado was aboard, the winning owner, Lawrence Foggle, LLC. It's Time to Laugh paid $4.60 to win. That'll take us right to the second race, a $6,250 claimer. Three-year-olds and up will be sprinting 6 furlongs on the main track. Scratch the 1, the 2, and the 8.
They're up. Last in, first out, it's Smoking the Field who gets the first call. Helper Rye moves up and from between horses. Pecorino is away in the top flight. He's in fact second, settling in off Helper Rye, who has the lead. Smoking the Field rein back to run third from fourth now. That's Beantown Skipper, and it's a stretch of 6 lengths to the trailer. The trailer is Favorite Uncle. Down the back stretch they go. Helper Rye on the inside, Pecorino on the outside. They're a length better than an inside running Beantown Skipper. Then Smoking the Field spotted about 2.5 lengths off the lead under Josie Gomez, and it's a distance to Favorite Uncle. They moved to the far turn. They went 23-2 for a casual opening quarter speed. There's 3 furlongs left to go. Moving up on the outside, Pecorino and Gaffleone taking it to Helper Rye. They've noticeably quickened. They're 4 better than Smoking the Field and Beantown Skipper as they run to the top of the stretch. Gaffleone just went to the stick on Pecorino, trying to get him to collar Helper Rye. Back third is Smoking the Field, 3 better than Beantown Skipper with 3/16 to go. Helper Rye is doggedly hanging on here. In fact, he's turning away Pecorino. Back third is Smoking the Field. Final furlong. Pecorino trying to re-rally at Helper Rye. Helper Rye has the lead. Pecorino just outrun today, and he's outrun by Helper Rye, who wins it by a length and a half. Pecorino was second. Smoking the Field is third in front of Beantown Skipper and Favorite Uncle in 1:10 flat.
Helper Rye holds off Pecorino to take the second race. Amisael Jaramillo was in the irons for trainer Oscar Gonzalez and owners Vicente Stella Stables, LLC. Helper Rye returns $29.80 for the win.
Charmin goes down the outside. Charmin goes chasing Danish Dynaformer. Danish Dynaformer, Charmin goes. And Charmin Ghost takes the Queen's Plate a length.
And taking the 156th running of the Queen's Plate is Charmin Ghost, beautifully bred by Ghost Zapper.
Classic bloodlines, classic sire, Ghost Zapper, standing at Adina Springs.
Race number 3 is a $12,500 claimer. Fillies and mares, 3-year-olds and up, which have not won 3 races, or 3-year-olds, will be going a mile on the main track. A field of 6 will go to the post.
They're off. From the center, Faith Hall will get the first call. From the inside, that's Tormenta De Oro showing a touch of speed. Mimi's Dream from down toward the rail mixing it up. These three are quickest. Angling off the fence is Summer's Back. She's now moving forward. She's a joint third. She's three better than Starship Cosmo, and the trailer is Fee and Sugar. They run out of the one-mile chute, and Faith Hall has the lead by a length now. Racing in second is Tormenta De Oro. Mimi's Dream comes off the fence to move up third. Two more to Summer's Back, who's now fourth, with Tormenta, or rather toward the inside, Starship Cosmo, and Fee and Sugar is the trailer. The opening quarter was spirited here, 23-2. Down the backstretch they go, and Tormenta De Oro down toward the inside, taking it to Faith Hall, who's on the outside. They're three better than Mimi's Dream, who gets the run of the race third. Starship Cosmo behind the speed with pace to chase from fourth after a 45.5 mile. Summer's Back has called it an afternoon, and Fee and Sugar is trying to get underway as they run around the far turn. Three furlongs left to go. Tormenta De Oro, three parts of a length. Faith Hall now asked to work from Nunez aboard second, running for Faith Hall, three better than an outside running Mimi's Dream. She's put to the whip ride. Starship Cosmo up the inside for McIntosh with a quarter of a mile left to go. Three quarters, 1:10-2. Lights out run here from the top horses as they run to the top of the stretch. Faith Hall just took the lead. Starship Cosmo's the danger up the inside. Back third is Tormenta De Oro. Back fourth is Mimi's Dream. Final furlong, Faith Hall and Nunez finding plenty. Starship Cosmo up the inside, then Tormenta De Oro, but Faith Hall extra sharp today, and Faith Hall moving away to win it on the wire by two. Second, Starship Cosmo. Third, Tormenta De Oro. And fourth was Mimi's Dream. They covered the course in 1:37-4.
Faith Hall kicks clear to take the third race, winning her second start off a six-month layoff. Eduardo Nunez was aboard for trainer Kathleen O'Connell, the winning owner's Whitehall Lane Farm. Faith Hall paid $6 to win. Race number four is a maiden special weight. Two-year-old fillies will be going 7.5 furlongs on the turf course. 10 will go to the post here.
They're up. From the center, that's Tizjet who gets the first call, but here's Masio moving up toward the inside. Tizboa from the outside is showing speed today, and China Bella comes away in the top flight as they run to the first turn. It will be Masio who leads the way from Tizjet, who's racing second now. From the outside and Tizboa from the rail, it's China Bella. Moving four wide through the initial stages is Previous Version. Behind me in battled pace setters is Blackmail. It's a length and a half to Run Alex Run, who's three lengths better than Flyer in the Sky. It's a stretch of another 2.5 lengths back to Seeking the Storm, and Panetta's the trailer. They move into the backstretch now. Masio, 6-5, and has the lead. Three wide Previous Version in the two-path Tizboa. They went 24 seconds flat for the opening quarter speed. Racing fourth behind the embattled pace setters is China Bella from Tizjet, who's on hold between horses fifth. Toward the outside, that's Blackmail, a length and a half in front of an improving Flyer in the Sky. Then back to Run Alex Run, Seeking the Storm is second last, and Panetta is the trailer. They move now to the far turn after the opening half mile, and with the lead, it's still Basio, three parts of a length, 48-1 for a half mile. From the outside, Tizboa second. Previous Version is next. Tizjet three wide, covering ground now. Toward the rail, that's China Bella, then Run Alex Run. Trying to get underway from the back is Seeking the Storm as they run to the top of the stretch. Masio still has the lead. China Bella and Tizjet second and third. Back fourth is Run Alex Run. Tizboa's called it an afternoon, and they're at the top of the stretch. It's Masio who turns first. China Bella is set down driving, trying to track the leader down. Back third is Tizjet, then Run Alex Run. Inside the final furlong, Masio bracing for the challenge of China Bella. China Bella now puts her head in front. Masio's back to second. Here's Run Alex Run. She'll get second. And China Bella springs the upset under Miguel Vasquez to win it by 2.5. Second, Run Alex Run. It is close for third between Tizjet and Masio in 1:32-1.
China Bella runs down the front-running Masio to take the fourth race. Miguel Vasquez was in the irons for trainer Juan Andres Rodriguez and owners Teamwork Horseman Group and Teamwork Racing. China Bella paid $39 to win. The fifth race is a $25,000 maiden claiming event that kicks off the Rainbow Six. Two-year-olds will be sprinting 6 furlongs on the main track. Scratch the 4, wanna follow me.
They're up. Kimchi Strike from the outside with Alex the Dude breaking alertly. Down to the rail, here's run from Partagas Way and Awesome Louie. Awesome Louie on the offensive to take the lead by a length and a quarter. Racing second is Partagas Way. He'll work off the fence for a clear shot. He's a length and a half better than Alex the Dude, who's now third. From between horses, that's Unspoken Quality alongside Kimchi Strike. Wide on the course is Moranazo. Two better than Cyber Josh, and the early trailer is Let's Go, Irishman. They speed into the far turn. They went a quarter in 22-4. They swing around the far turn, and on top here, it's still Awesome Louie by three. On the inside, Unspoken Quality, Partagas Way is scrubbed on. Alex the Dude rallies well three wide. Kimchi Strike is four wide, but he's also coming on. He's two and a half better than Moranazo as they run to the top of the stretch. Awesome Louie's under a shove now from Alex the Dude and trying to work off the fence, Unspoken Quality. Kimchi Strike swung into action. He's on the outside and coming on. 46-3 for an opening half mile. They're into the stretch. Final furlong to go. Kimchi Strike driving up on the outside of Alex the Dude. These two to set the score. Three better than Moranazo. Final furlong. Alex the Dude digging in. Kimchi Strike trying to press pass late. Alex the Dude. Kimchi Strike. Alex the Dude is hanging on. Kimchi Strike is second. Unspoken Quality third. Then Moranazo in 1-12-3.
Alex the Dude outduels Kimchi Strike to take the fifth race, breaking his maiden in his fourth career start for trainer Ralph Nix. Tyler Gaffleone was the winning rider. For winning owner Donald R. Disney, LLC, Alex the Dude paid $11.80 to win.
There's a new day dawning in Florida. Never before has a Breeders' Cup Classic winner retired to stud in the Sunshine State. Until now. Adina Springs presents three-time Grade 1 winner and earner of over $4 million, Fort Larned. New to Adina Springs South.
The sixth race is today's feature. This is the $75,000 Hard Worker Stakes. Fillies and mares, three-year-olds and up, will be sprinting five furlongs on the turf course. Scratch the four and the six.
And they're off for the Hard Worker Stakes. Toward the rail, Perfect Step gets the first call, but quickly up to take the lead is the favorite, Our Free Roll. And Our Free Roll extends to three parts of a length in front over Angie's Prim Lady, who races in second now. Perfect Step and Our Liberty Bay, third and fourth. Then it's Zam Quick, and the early trailer is Red Minx. They take it to the far turn. Our Free Roll has company today in the form of Angie's Prim Lady, who's forcing the issue while second, three better than Perfect Step, who's now third. Racing fourth is Liberty Bay, followed by Zam Quick, and Red Minx rides the rail sixth and last as they run around the far turn. Our Free Roll on the inside. Angie's Prim Lady giving her all she wants on the outside. Two and a half lengths back to Perfect Step, who's had a perfect run of it. Here comes Zam Quick from the back, and they're at the top of the stretch. Zayas goes to work on Our Free Roll, but here's Perfect Step on the outside. And Perfect Step and Prado just ran up to take the lead. Perfect Step has been making all the right steps the last 2 months, and she's now won four in a row. Up second is Zam Quick. Third, Angie's Prim Lady, then Red Minx and Our Free Roll. And 56 flat.
Perfect Step notches her fourth consecutive victory and first stakes score in taking the Hard Worker. Edgar Prado, he notches his second victory of the day. This one's for trainer Peter Walder and owners Matthew Newman and Aventura Stable. They claimed Perfect Step just two starts ago. Today she paid $9.20 to win. Race number seven is a $35,000 claiming event. Two-year-olds will be sprinting five and a half furlongs on the main track.
And they're off. Bayzad's Pride was off a step slow. From the inside, it's Prayer and a Song who reaches out to take the early lead. Moving up is Turkey Ridge and Bon Voyage, second and third. Driving up on the rail, Flashing Light to join the vanguard. From the outside, that's Title Flight in the top flight. Alongside him is Fancy Flash. It's a stretch of two and a half lengths to the trailer as Benzaz Pride. He's had a subpar beginning, and he's seventh and last as they run around the far turn. Prayer and a Song has the lead. Bon Voyage draws alongside at the 3/8, a length and a half better than Flashing Light. Moving up on the outside is Title Fight. Here's Bayzad Sports Pride also kickstarting a rally. Turkey Ridge is second last, and the trailer now is Fancy Flash. They run past the quarter-mile pole and toward the inside. Prayer and a Song has the lead. Bon Voyage will have to do better from second toward the outside. Bezod's Prize is on a roll now. Bezod's Pride missed the start, but he's coming on inside the final furlong. Here's Bezod's Pride over the top, taking over from Prayer and a Song. Then to the inside, it's Flashing Light. Bon Voyage and Title Fighter next. But inside the 16th pole, let there be no doubt who's best. The best is Bezod's Pride, moving away by three. Flashing Light second, close third, either Bon Voyage or Prayer and a Song in 105 and 3.
Bezod's Pride follows up a dominant maiden-breaking score to notch his second straight win in the seventh race. Josie Gomez was your winning rider for trainer Antonio Sano and owner John Paul Chabotti. Bezod's Pride paid $10.40 to win. Let's get to the eighth race, a $25,000 to $30,000 claimer. Three-year-olds and up, which have not won two races, will be sprinting five furlongs on the turf course.
And they're off. Remembering Richie begins nicely, moving up on the inside and showing speed today is Super C Me. He's up to take the lead. Away Racing in third now is Better Run Real Fast, followed by Redamite from the top shelf. Here's Harry He and Swagger trying to get over. Now ducking and off that speed is Boyfriend's Back. Stretch of five lengths to Simon the Serenian, and trailing the field is Benny Likes Girls. They take it around the far turn. Super C Me has the lead. Racing in second is Remembering Richie up on the outside, and moving up is Swagger. From between them, Redamite, no place to go. Better Run Real Fast and Harry He are right there. Two lengths better than Boyfriend's Back as they run to the top of the stretch. They went 21-4 for the opening quarter speed. Super C Me still confidently handled and still with the lead. Toward the inside, Better Run Real Fast. Toward the outside, Remembering Richie. Back forth is Redamite. Final furlong, Super C Me digging in gamely. Remembering Richie with the final surge on the outside. Better Run Real Fast is third. Coming to the finish, Super C Me. They can't. He's in front. Second was Remembering Richie in front of Better Run Real Fast at 56-3.
Super C Me cannot be caught in the eighth race. Eddie Castro was the winning rider for trainer George Navarro and owners JN Racing Stables, Inc. Super C Me paid $8.40 to win. The ninth race is an allowance. Three-year-olds and up will be sprinting six furlongs on the main track. Scratch the six, Diabolical IPA.
They're up. From the outside, Color Me Pom Pom begins nicely. Here's Galar Donato in the lime colors moving to take the lead. Focus on Me is away in the top flight. He's now second. Hector's Pride is reined back to run in fourth. He's a length and a half better than King Rontos with Bluegrass Luck. Second last is Running Cat, and it's 2.5 lengths to the early trailer, Heat Star. Past the half-mile mark and taking it to the far turn, Galar Donato on top 3/4 of a length. Focus on Me is there, second. Color Me Pom Pom third. King Rontos rides the rail from fourth in front of Hector's Pride and Bluegrass Luck. Three more to Running Cat and 2.5 to Heat Star. Three furlongs left to go now, and on top it's Galar Donato, the favorite. Focus on Me just came under a ride as Color Me Pom Pom moves up on his outside. Bluegrass Luck is now racing in fourth, a length better than Hector's Pride fifth, and there's 1/4 mile left to go. Color Me Pom Pom just bit up to take the lead. Galar Donato comes under a ride, but he's not done fighting. He's coming right back. Racing third is Focus on Me from Hector's Pride fourth, and there's 1/8 mile to go. Galar Donato on the top end. Here's Focus on Me with a rebit on the outside from between him and Color Me Pom Pom. Focus on Me re-rallies to win. Focus on Me is focused in the end to win at 3/4 of a length. Second, Galar Donato, then Color Me Pom Pom and Hector's Pride in 109-3.
Focus on Me is positively tenacious in victory in the ninth race. That's his second straight win. Miguel Vasquez was aboard. David Brady was the winning trainer for winning owners Champion Equine LLC. Focus on Me paid $4.40 to win. The 10th and final race on today's program is a $12,500 maiden claimer. Fillies and mares 3-year-olds and up will be sprinting 5 furlongs on the turf course. 9 will go to the post in the super high five race of the day.
And runners away. From the center, you feel this. Cornelius is away the best. Pam Pam comes away with speed. Down to the inside, that's Rockstar Queen, who's away in the top flight. She's third early. From the outside, moving closer now is Spring Me. In between horses, Miss Regal Light. Circle of Trust is getting underway. She's to the outside of Elite Flyer, who rides the rail. Stretch of 2.5 lengths back to the two trailers, Tricky Entry and Me Rhapsody. They speed around the far turn, and you feel this. Cornelius, she shakes free and leads it by 2.5. Pam Pam is second on the outside. Now third is Spring Me. Racing in fourth is Circle of Trust in front of Me Rhapsody, and a bit tight there is Miss Regal Light, and they run to the top of the stretch. There's a quarter of a mile left to go. You feel this. Cornelius trying to seal the deal. 3 lengths in front. Pam Pam is second. Spring Me is third. Circle of Trust is battling on, trying to get fourth now. Then to the outside of Miss Regal Light inside the final furlong with the lead. You feel this. Cornelius in front by 5 lengths. Pam Pam is second. Spring Me is third. Photo for fourth. It's You Feel This, Cornelius, the winner. Second is Pam Pam. Third is Spring Me. Miss Regal Light was fourth, and fifth was Circle of Trust in 56-4.
You Feel This, Cornelius sprints to victory in the 10th race. Edgard Zayas was in the irons for trainer Sally Mitchell Hill and owners Acclaimed Racing Stable and Grimster Stable LLC. You Feel This, Cornelius paid $5.80 to win. And here's how our exotic wagers paid today. The pick 4, 4 of 4 returned $75.95. The pick 5, 4 of 5, $8.20. 5 of 5, $395.25. The rainbow 6, 6 of 6, $729.88. There will be a carryover heading into Saturday's card of $4,848.53.
That's going to do it for Friday's program. We have more stakes action tomorrow. On Saturday, the Sensitive Prince will feature 3-year-olds and up, and they'll be going a mile and a 16th on the main track. The field includes Grade 2 Indiana Derby winner East Hall, as well as Letical, who has just been on fire here at Gulfstream this spring. And Super Lucky will ship in for the race for trainer Michael Trombetta. He was most recently 6th in the Aladar Stakes up at Saratoga behind Bay of Plenty. But before that, he won an allowance at Laurel at this very distance. And earlier in May, he ran 3rd to 2014 Belmont Stakes winner Tonalist in the Grade 3 Westchester at Belmont. He's going to be seeking his first ever stakes store, but he may be the class of this field, and we'll see if he can break through and get that elusive stakes win tomorrow. It's going to be another fun day of racing at Gulfstream, so be here to enjoy it. Thanks for watching Thoroughbred Action. For all of us here at Gulfstream, I'm Katie Stazak.